Hey, welcome to Robinson Foundry. In today's video, I'll show you how I turned 1,000 copper pennies into a solid copper hammer. First, I came up with a design that I was happy with, and then I built off of that design and made a pattern that I could use to make a sand mold, and I'll explain why it looks the way it does in a minute. I printed part of this pattern on my Bamboo Lab X1 Carbon, which was supplied to me by Bamboo Lab. I actually like this printer so much that I bought another one of their printers, and if you want to check them out, then I'll have an affiliate link in the description. So this is what the hammer's going to look like, but I can't just make a mold using this, so that's why I made this a weird looking pattern. I'll cast the hammer vertically, and the mold will fill from the bottom up. This large piece on the top is called a riser, and it'll supply the casting with metal as it solidifies and shrinks. And I'll use these purple pieces as a mold to make a core using sand and sodium silicate. The core is what will form the hole running through the hammer, which is called an eye. If I'm not explaining it very well, things will start to make a lot more sense as the video progresses. Now it's time to make a mold. I've shown this process many times in my videos, so I won't go into a lot of detail, but as usual, I'll use this oil-bonded sand called petrobond. As far as molds go, this one's fairly simple, especially because I'm going to be casting it vertically. I need to cut a sprue on each side of the mold in the exact same location, so I'm using baby powder as a way to transfer the location from one side to the other. And here's where that core comes in. I'll just leave it right here, and the metal should flow around it, forming a hole that goes through the hammerhead. This is $10 in pre-1982 pennies. There should be plenty to fill the mold with just a little bit left over to pour some ingots. And don't worry, besides one with a weird double-stamped 1955, which I just threw back in with the others, there weren't any interesting-looking pennies in here. These pennies are 95% copper and 5% zinc. You can see some white smoke coming off of the crucible, and that's the zinc burning off. It's not much, but it's still enough to need to wear a respirator because breathing zinc oxide can make you very sick with what's called metal fume fever. I did consider pouring this 2,000 degree copper while wearing nothing but shorts and flip-flops, like you see so many other people doing online, but I decided against it, and well, I was glad I did. I was fine, by the way, I didn't get burned at all. Well, this looks really good. The casting filled out just the way I had hoped it would, so now I can get to work cleaning it up. There's a little void here from either gas or shrinkage, but it's not really a problem. I'll be able to just file it out. Sometimes I design something without thinking about how much file work will be involved in cleaning it up, and then I kick myself. This is definitely one of those times, though I do enjoy filing to some degree. I've been using my new file handles, which I made a video about a few months ago, and I have to say, I like them a lot. They can be a bit cumbersome at times, but for the most part, I really do like using them. Once all the file work was finished, I buffed out all the file marks with my belt grinder, followed by a die grinder. Well, I think this looks great, so now I can start making a handle out of a piece of hickory. I have this large ball peen hammer that's just about the same size, so I'm going to use it as a template. When I make a handle from scratch like this, I like to start with shaping the eye or the part that fits into the hammerhead first, because I find that that's the easiest way to keep everything aligned. Now that that's fitting properly, I can start with shaping the handle. I'm using an overhead shop light to cast a shadow onto the wood so that I can accurately trace the shape of the handle onto it. Now it's just a simple matter of cutting everything away that isn't a handle. Well, that wasn't too bad. I'm getting faster at making these handles, but they still take several hours to make. Before I can attach the handle to the head, I need to file a slight taper into the eye to keep the handle from coming off when I pound in a wedge. I could design this into the mold, but it's simple enough to just file it in, and it really doesn't need much. Now all I have to do is pound in a wedge, and this thing is done. I gotta say, I think this thing looks really nice, and I'm gonna have a hard time actually using it. Whenever I make something like this, I have a strong sense of satisfaction. And in this case, I'm amazed that not too long ago this was a bunch of pennies and a piece of wood, and now I have something that I can pass down to my children. I think that's pretty cool. If you want to give this a shot yourself, then I'll have the 3D printing files available on my Patreon. As always, I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, let me know what you think in the comments, give the video a thumbs up, and subscribe for future projects. Well, thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.